Hello, welcome again. Now let's have a quick review of last lecture, what we had. See, in the last lecture we had two types of amplifier, bypassed amplifier and unbypassed amplifier, and for both of the amplifiers we have this equivalent diagram. And now in this lecture we are going to analyze those amplifiers. Is it? That is single stage RC coupled CE bypassed amplifier and CE unbypassed amplifier. And now see, in the last lecture we have defined some parameters, that is ZI, ZB, ZC and ZO. Then again student got a confusion and they asked, okay, sir, if we are writing RI as an input impedance, this RI as an input impedance, then what is this ZI? So they basically got confused between RI and ZI, correct? So now for those who called me and got confused completely, for them and for rest of us, let me rename this ZI. Let me rename this ZI with RI. Why? Because this ZI is an input impedance, and even I am writing RI as a traditional notation for input impedance. Is it? Let me take the same color, and now here let me write RI, that is input impedance. Now guys, it is okay. See, I am avoiding your confusion that you got between ZI and RI. Now here, instead of this ZI, I will use the term RI, and instead of this ZO, I will use the term RO. Is it okay? This ZO should not be there, it will be RO. I'm just changing notation, well, just because my students should not confused. Is it? Some people think that we are having some extra parameters, something like ZI, ZO and RIRO. So it's not like that. ZI is basically what RI and ZO is RO. So that's why now confusion should not be there. Now we can start with our analysis. Let us draw the same line. Now here in the left hand side, we will derive equation for input impedance, output impedance and then AVAI for bypassed amplifier. And for unbypassed amplifier, we'll write here parallelly in the right hand side. Is it? Now let us start with the first parameter that we are going to start with is input impedance. Okay, let me write it here, input impedance. And the notation that I am going to use for input impedance is RI. Now it is same as that we said and we have written in the diagram. See, RI is here, RI is here, and that's what RI I am going to derive. Is it? For bypassed amplifier. Again, for unbypassed amplifier also, I will write input impedance, and the notation, that is same notation I will use, that is RI. It is done now. Look at this. What is this RI? This RI is a parallel combination. Now let me change the pen. It is a parallel combination of R1 and R2. What we call this? We call this as an RB. This RB is in parallel with ZB. What is that ZB? Look at this. Input impedance of the base of the transistor. Is it? That's why I am writing ZB. Is it? So it is input impedance at the base of the transistor. So it means that RI, what I can say, what is that RI? It is RB in parallel with ZB. RB in parallel with Z. It looks like Z. Yes, RB in parallel with ZB. But what is RB? RB is nothing but R1 parallel with R2. That is something which is in bracket. So what is RI, input impedance? It is RB in parallel with ZB. Now come to the left hand side. I will write equation for RI. What is that RI? R I is R B in parallel with Z O Z B. The equation will remain same here. R I is equals to what? It is R B in parallel with Z B. Now R B is known. What is R B? R B is R 1 in parallel with R 2. But we don't know what is ZB. ZB is what? ZB that we need to derive. Is it? Same thing is here. Let me delete unwanted things. Let me correct this RB first. Let me delete this. Now this is ZB. And this is, okay, now things are clear. RB in parallel with ZB is nothing but your RI. RB is well known, that is R1 in parallel with R2. Is it? We know voltage divider bias circuit, so it is well known to everyone. Now what about ZB? What is this ZB? Now observe only bypassed amplifier. Don't even look at the unbypassed amplifier, the right hand side. Ignore it completely. Focus on left hand side, bypassed amplifier. So what is this bypassed amplifier? ZB. ZB is input impedance to the base. Is it? If I am saying input impedance to the base, so what is coming in ZB area? Okay. Is there any undo button? Do we have undo button? Yes, we have it. It's not working. Work it. Let me check. It is ZB. Now come to the diagram. Now what I am interested in, let me change the pen. Let me take a marker, and this is what area of ZB. Is it? What comes under the area of ZB? Only HIE is there. Is it? So this ZB means only one impedance, that is HIE. So for bypassed amplifier, look at this, for bypassed amplifier, this RB is nothing but R1 in parallel with R2, and ZB is nothing but HIE. Is it? So it means what is RI for bypassed amplifier? It is R1 in parallel with R2, that is RB in parallel with HIE. Yes, and that's it. See, derivation for the input impedance for bypassed amplifier, isn't it so simple? Just RB in parallel with HI. Is it? Yes, and the thing is done. many cases write that RI is equals to HIE approximately. They write like this. Now I'll tell you why in many books they are writing RI is equals to HI. Because they assume that value of RB is greater than value of HIE. So if value of RB is very very greater than value of HIE, it means a large value of resistance is in parallel with small value of resistance. So we know the thumb rule, then what will be the equivalent impedance? It is equals to HIE. So that's why they write RI is equals to HIE approximately. Is it? That's what I will write here, approx. This is what approximate equation for input impedance for bypassed amplifier. Is it? So this thing is clear. Let us move towards unbypassed amplifier. And here for unbypassed amplifier, we have a nice procedure. Is it? Now let us follow the procedure. It's not happening. Okay, let me check whether I can move like this. Yes, I can move like this. Now at this side, look at this. RI is equals to RB in parallel with ZB. Is it? So RB thing is known. R1 parallel with RB. Sorry, R1 parallel with R2. Now what is that ZB? We need to hunt for ZB. We will derive what is ZB. What ZB is what? Input impedance, or simply impedance at the base of the transistor. Now come here in the diagram. What is there at the base of the transistor, or what is the area of ZB? Look at this. this whole thing comes in the area of ZB. This is what area of ZB. For that area, I need to find the impedance. Is it? So let me find it. How can I find the impedance? So what is the input voltage? It is Vi. Is it? So let me work on this path. Is it? Let me work on this path. Why? Because this is an input loop. From the input side, I have input loop. So if I work on this path, I know what is the current. The current flowing through the path is IB. Yes, is it not? Now this is the current which is flowing through resistor RE. Obviously, give the name it as IE. And this is the current flowing from the collector IC. Is it? Basic equation is known to everyone. IE is equals to IC plus IB. Obviously, the current is a summation of base current and collector current. Is it? So, by having this basic equation and by applying KVL to the input loop, let me write what is ZB. Okay, let me be there on the screen because I want this equivalent diagram and the equation parallelly. So, I will write equation for input impedance. Input impedance. Is it? Now, what is input impedance? It is apply KVL to the input path. Now, let me apply KVL to the input path. Vi is equals to then, it is IB multiplied by HIE. The thing is clear? IB is flowing through HIE. Yes, IB is flowing through HIE. Here, it is HIE plus. Now, plus. Another voltage, that is IE multiplied by I. That's what it is, IE. This, look at this. There is a resistance HIE, current flowing through this is IB. There is a resistance RE, current flowing through it is IE. So that's what I have written. Now let us simplify. Let us simplify. See, the steps that I am going to follow is I have applied KVL to the input loop. That's what Vi is equals to IBHIE plus RE multiplied by IE. So why I am doing this? Because I am interested in, look at this, we are interested ZB. Is it? We are interested in ZB. ZB means what? Input impedance, or what I can say, impedance at the base. So impedance at the base will be obviously input voltage divided by input current. Yes, is it not? It means, clearly I can say, input voltage means V, input current means IB. So VI multiplied by IB is what ZB is. That's what I am going to get finally. Is it? But to get VI divided by IB, okay, B positive, everywhere I am writing capital B. No, it's a small b. Sorry, let me have it. Now this is what? A small b I have written. So the job is, the task is, the purpose is to get ZB, that is Vi by IB ratio, and for that I have written equation by applying KVL. Look at here, this is what equation, and now let me copy the equation. No, it's not done. Something went wrong. Okay, let's rewrite the equation again. Apply KVL to base loop. Apply KVL to the base loop. And now if I apply KVL to the base loop, what I will get? It is IB multiplied by HIE plus IE multiplied by RE. Is it? Now, I will use this simplification, that is IE is nothing but what? It is IC plus IB. That's what. Now let me simplify this again. It is IB multiplied by HIE plus IC RE plus IB multiplied by RE. Again I will simplify this with IC is equals to HFEIB. I'll put the value of IC, which is equals to HFEIB. So here I will write HFEIB multiply by RE plus IB multiply by RE. Now see, in the first term IB is there, in the second term IB is there, third term IB is there. So let me take this IB. Let me take that IB common. Now IB is equals to what? Now it is, sorry, VI is equals to IB in bracket HIE. Okay, in second term what I left with? HFERE. So I will write HFE multiply by RE, HFE dot. In the third term what I left with? Only RE. Yes, this is what. Now again observe the equation. What I can have? I can have RE in the second term. RE is there. So I will now take RE as a common term and I will write HFE plus 1, or you can simply write 1 plus HFE. No problem. This is what input voltage VI. Now simplify this. VI divided by IB IE plus RE multiplied by 1 plus HFE. Now what is this VI divided by IB? Just look at this. VI divided by IB. What is that? Isn't it VI divided by IB? What it shows? VI divided by IB is nothing but your ZB. So let me turn towards VI divided by IB is nothing but ZB. So ZB equals to HIE plus RE divided by 1 plus HFE. This is what my ZB. Just check, it is ZB. Now, what is the actual aim, actual purpose? The actual purpose is to find out input impedance. What is that input impedance? It is RB in parallel with ZB. Is it? So it means it is RB in parallel with, now write down this equation, HIE plus RE multiplied by 1 plus HFE. Okay, let me have this term. Is it? Yes, can I write like this? And now that will be, okay, let me rewrite the equation to make a box and conclude RI is equals to RB in bracket HIE plus RE in bracket 1 plus HFE. And this is what input impedance for unbypassed amplifier. See, the input impedance for bypassed amplifier is so simple. Look at this, compare both equations, compare both side instead. Is it? Both sides, look at this. Now in left hand side we have equation only RI is equals to HI, or simply RI is equals to RB plus HI. But here in case of bypass amplifier, look at the process. We have large procedure, is it? And that is the reason analysis for unbypassed amplifier is quite critical. Is it? Now, okay, this is the first parameter that we are done with. That is input impedance. Now, let us move towards the second parameter. The second parameter that we are going to derive is which one to select. Okay, as we are in impedance, that is input impedance, let us start with output impedance. Is it? So let me start with output impedance now. The input impedance part is done. Well, you remember that input impedance for a bypassed amplifier and for unbypassed amplifier, that we are done with. So for bypassed amplifier, input impedance is approximately HIE. Is it? Why we have written HIE? Because actually the equation that we got is RI is equals to RB in parallel with HIE. But if RB is very large as compared to HIE, then it will be only HIE. Now in case of unbypassed amplifier, look at this. In case of unbypassed amplifier, we have equation which is quite different from bypassed amplifier. Look at this. It is RB in parallel with HIE plus RE 1 plus HFE. So that this are we missing that in parallel sign? Look at this, RB in parallel with that. Now as input part is done, let's move towards the output part, that is output impedance, is it? Now let's have the output impedance. Again, output impedance we will write. Now look at this. What the notation we have used? It is RO. Yes, it is RO. That is output impedance or output resistance. Now output resistance for bypassed amplifier. Look at this. Output resistance for bypassed amplifier. Come to the output part for the same circuit. So output part, what we have? We have ZC, means output impedance at the collector. So what is the output impedance at the collector? Output impedance at the collector, see, there is nothing because collector is directly connected to a ground and we have only a current source in between, is it? So for a bypassed amplifier, whatever output impedance is there with only RC, so clearly I can write output impedance for this output impedance RO will be equals to RC, because collector resistor is the only resistor present at the output, is it? Now if you want to connect load resistor RL, or consider that we have load resistor RL, then we can modify the same equation as output impedance is equals to RC in parallel with RL, and that's it. Yes, this is the final thing. Yes, we are done. Now as if we are done with RO, that is RC in parallel with RL, if you don't connect RL, then RO, that is output impedance, is simply collector impedance, is it? Now can I have same thing if I consider this part, that is unbypassed amplifier. Now come to the unbypassed amplifiers. Now for unbypassed amplifier, where we have written, for unbypassed amplifier, let me write it here. Output impedance, the same thing we will write, RO, and here also I can have the same equation, RO is equals to RC in parallel with RL, is it? Why I am writing same equation? Because no matter whether it is bypassed amplifier or unbypassed amplifier, see, at the output we have only two resistors, that is one is RC, another one is RL. So even if input impedances are different for bypassed and unbypassed amplifier, but still output impedances will be same, because output part for both the amplifiers is same, is it? So for bypassed amplifier as well as for unbypassed amplifier, we have to write same equation, that is RC in parallel with RL. That's what it is. Now moving towards the next thing, that is the another parameter. Let me draw a line. Now this is here, this is what our area will work here only, because see, we are wasting a time in scrolling the page itself. So now let us start with the third parameter. Let me write number 3. Now, what is that number 3? It is voltage gain. So let me write it clearly. It is voltage gain. is it? And the notation that we are using traditionally is AV. So now voltage gain, first we will write voltage gain for bypassed amplifier. I will write here bypass amplifier. Is it? So as if I am working for bypass amplifier, let me copy this circuit diagram. Let me have this. Let me check whether I can. Yes, it is possible. Now here I will paste it. Now look at this, I am in voltage gain AV. Now what is that AV? AV is simply equals to output voltage divided by input voltage. Is it? Now look at the figure. What is the output voltage and what is the input voltage? Now, let me write equation for output voltage. Is it? From above figure, what I can write? I can write VO, that is output voltage, is equals to, look at this, output current multiply by output resistances. Is it not? Because output current multiply by output resistance is equals to output voltage. Yes, it is a very simple thing. Now input voltage, by same way, can I write input voltage Vin? Yes, obviously it is input current multiply by input impedance. Now what is there at the input side? We have only HIE. Why we have only HIE? Because RB in parallel with HIE is the final equation, but RB, I am considering that RB is very very less, so that's why, sorry, RB is very very greater than HIE, so HIE is a very small value, so that's why HIE will remain there only. Now let me take a ratio of that. That is AV is equals to, see, as if I am writing approximate H module, obviously I need to consider approximate equations. Is it? Here, if you don't understand, here I will write RI is equals to HIE, because RB is very very greater than HIE. Is it? That's what the final assumption. Now voltage gain is equals to, now take a ratio IC multiply by RC in parallel with RL divided by IB multiply by HIE. That's what. Now look at this. What I can have? This ratio of IC and IB. What that ratio indicates? IC divided by IB. What is that? We know that IC divided by IB is nothing but my HFE. Is it? So I will modify the equation and then I will write equation as it is HFE multiplied by RC in parallel with RL divided by HIE. And this is what my voltage gain. This is voltage gain for bypassed amplifier. Is it? Further, if you don't have this load resistor in your circuit, see, generally load resistor we never connect, so if you don't have this, then clearly I will write HFE multiply by RC divided by HIE. So every time we use this approximate equation, that is HFE RC divided by HIE. Okay? If you want to use exact equation, then what it will be, or it has to be an exact form. Exact form should be AV is equals to HFE multiply by RC in parallel with RL divided by RB in parallel with HIE. That's what the exact form. But see, we are using approximate form. Approximate thing, what is the approximate thing? RB is very very greater than HIE. So neglect RB, only HIE will be there. Is it? RL, if you don't connect, connect only RC. So HF RC divided by HIE. That is the equation, that is the practical equation we are using while designing all those bypassed amplifiers. Is it? Now, we know that it is a common emitter amplifier. So, common emitter amplifier we are dealing with, and it gives 180 degree phase shift. Is it? So, in some cases, what you will find? You will find that AV is equals to, some people write, minus HFE multiplied by RC divided by HIE. So, even if you see this minus sign, then also don't get confused, because this minus sign is simply because of this 180 degree phase shift. Is it? So, as 180 degree phase shift means opposite phase. So, opposite phase means minus sign. Is it? So, for the time being, we are dealing only with the magnitude and not with the phase. So, that's why don't even think about whether it is minus sign or plus sign. Just stick to HFERC divided by HIE. Now, turn towards the unbypassed amplifier. Because this is what voltage gain for bypassed amplifier. Now, in case of unbypassed amplifier, see, one equation is well known to us. Let me write here, for unbypass amplifier. Is it? Now, for unbypassed amplifiers, you remember we have written one equation, that is input voltage VI is equals to IB multiplied by HIE plus RE multiplied by 1 plus HFE. Now, this is the equation we have written, you remember where? In case of input impedance. Yes, let me show you where we have written exactly. This is what actual equation. Is it? HIE plus RE 1 plus HFE. Is it? Now, this equation which is already derived. So, I am using this derived equation. Why to do the same thing again and again? Is it? We are not going to repeat the things. So, that's why we will enter into full screen and we will stay here. Input voltage equals to IB multiplied by HIE plus RE 1 plus HFE. Is it? Now, output voltage. See, basically what we are interested in, we are interested in voltage gain. So, what is voltage gain? Voltage gain is output voltage divided by input voltage. Is it? So, this is what equation for the input voltage, which is already derived. Is it? Derived in the expression of input impedance. Is it? So, already it is known. Now, come to the output voltage. So, what is output voltage? So, this output voltage VO is equals to IC multiplied by RC parallel RE. Yes, that's what it is, because output voltage is nothing but what? Output resistance multiplied by output current. So, output resistance you can simply write RC parallel RL, or you can write only RC. It depends whether you are connecting a load resistor or not. But simply consider that I am using load resistor, as I have shown that load resistor with the dotted line. It is where, no matter whether it is optional or what. See, consider that I have load resistor. So, write equation and analyze it with the help of RL. Now, voltage gain, AV. Now, what is that voltage gain? Voltage gain will be then IC multiplied by RC RL. Divided by, now what is that? It is output voltage. So, output voltage divided by input voltage. So, what is that input voltage? Input voltage is IB HIE 1 plus HFE. Remember, this is HFE. Now, this is the case. This is what my voltage gain. Now, see, again here what I can find, IC divided by IB. This term again comes here, it reflects clearly. So, we had the same thing in case of bypassed amplifier. Now here also in unbypassed amplifier we have the same thing, IC divided by ILC, and we are going to put it as HFE, is it? So this I am putting it as an HFE, is it? So what will be the final equation? Okay, let us write final equation as AV is equals to HFE. Why HFE? Because IC divided by IB is nothing but HFE, is it? So HFE in bracket RC in parallel with R. This similar kind of equations are there, divided by, now IB will not be there, only HIE plus RE. Now look at this, 1 plus HFE. Now okay, let me write this as an exact equation, is it? But see, I'm not dealing with any exact calculations. We are in approximate model, so everything should be approximate, is it? So as if I have derived one exact equation, let me turn towards the approximate thing. What is the approximate thing? Approximate thing is, look at this, 1 plus generally, or I can say usually, this RE multiply by 1 plus HFE. Okay, cancel it. Instead of multiplying with RE, we'll use only HFE term. Okay, let's towards 1 plus HFE. Can I say it is nothing but HFE? Because 330 plus 1 is approximately 330. So now I'm going to use this. 1 plus HFE is equals to HFE. This is the first approximation. Yes, and it is completely valid, is it? So then this term, look at this. This 1 plus HFE, now it becomes HFE. And that HFE can cancel with this HFE. It is okay? Yes. Now look at this. What remains with us? What are left with? I left with RE or HIE plus, now what I did, it is 1 plus HFE is equals to HFE. No, I can't put this. Wait a minute. This is HFE, HIE is still there in picture. So I can't do that because we have to somewhere consider HIE also, is it? Okay. So let me rub this also, because this is something where we have not considered HIE part, is it? So it means now what I can put, RE multiply 1 plus HFE, this whole thing is very very greater than HIE, because typical value of HIE is around 4.5k or 2.1k, is it? And HFE is 330 or 50 plus 1 multiplied by this RE. Value of RE is around 1k. So this value is always greater than HIE, is it? And it is very very greater than HIE. So it means what I left with, I left with only HFE divided by RE multiplied by 1 plus HFE. Now HIE is completely neglected. Here I can put 1 plus HFE is approximately nothing but HFE. Now this term will become HFE. Look at this. Now this term will become your HFE. That HFE and this HFE can be cancelled out. Now here I can do that, whatever I told you. And then finally what I'm getting, then I'm getting AV is equals to RC in parallel with RL divided by only RE, is it? Some people used to write equation with only RC because they don't connect RL at all. So RC divided by RE is the final approximate equation for voltage gain of unbypassed amplifier. Is it unbypassed amplifier means what? When I don't connect bypass capacitor, even I don't consider bypass capacitor. Is it? See, this is what your third parameter. The first parameter that we have seen is input impedance. The second parameter we have seen, and the third parameter is voltage gain for both the amplifiers, and bypassed amplifiers as well as unbypassed amplifiers. Is it? Now, the fourth parameter is nothing but your current gain. Is it? Let me start with current gain. I will write it is current gain. The AI. Now, what is current gain? Basically, current gain is nothing but your output current divided by input current. So, what is output current? In case of bypassed amplifier as well as in case of unbypassed amplifier, output current will remain same, and that will be IC. Right? There will not be any change. Now, at the input side, where you are applying input voltage, see, it is a common emitter amplifier that we have considered. Right? So, output current will always be collector current, and input current will always be the base current. So, IC divided by IB will be the equation for bypassed as well as unbypassed amplifier. Now, what is that IC divided by IB? What this thing shows, what this ratio shows, is that this is nothing but my HFE. In case of S parameter, this is HFE. So, current gain is equal to simply HFE for bypassed as well as unbypassed amplifier. Look at this. Bypass amplifier as well as unbypassed amplifier. The current gain is always HFE and it will never change. Is it? Now, isn't it? It is a very simple thing. The fourth parameter. See, as we have started with this gain, let me tell you the fifth parameter also. No matter whether I am using this fifth parameter or not, but let me tell you, it is a power gain. Look at this. Power gain, which also remains unchanged for bypassed amplifier as well as unbypassed amplifier. Now, what is that power gain? Or let me write the gain as AP. Power gain. What is that power gain? It is a multiplication of voltage gain and current gain. It simply means that nobody will going to ask you to calculate power gain. Is it? Because when you get the voltage gain and current gain, obviously nobody will ask you to calculate power gain, which is not useful because the power consumption of our circuit that we have designed here in the syllabus is very small. Is it? It is in milliwatt. Always it is in milliwatt. Is it? We'll never calculate a component which will give me a power ratings in watt. Hardly quarter watt, half watt resistors we are using. So, the power gain is not as much important, but still, as we have started with, I have covered this point here itself. So, this is what approximate hybrid module analysis is. It? So, can we have a nice summary about this bypassed and unbypassed amplifier? Is it? So, let me write the title as summary. Is it summary of all those parameters? Is it the title is summary? And then here in the first column I will write parameter. Okay, let me write here parameter. The second column I will write bypassed amplifier. And the third column I will write unbypassed amplifier. Let me draw a straight line, which is quite hard job. Now, the first parameter that we have derived is, what is the first parameter? It is input impedance. Input impedance. What happened to this? Okay, input impedance, and then short name is RI. Now, what is input impedance for this bypassed amplifier? It is RB in parallel with HIE. Is it? That is nothing but your HIE simply. Simply I'm writing HIE. Why? Because the RB is very, very greater than HIE. So that's why it is HIE. Even if you don't write RB in parallel with HIE, then also it is okay. This is purely valid. No problem at all. Now, in case of unbypassed amplifier, what is the equation we have? In case of unbypassed amplifier, we have a large equation, that is RB in parallel with a large thing, that is HIE plus IE 1 plus HFE. That's what. Look at this. This is input impedance for unbypassed amplifier. This is the first parameter that we have derived. As if I am writing summary, the second parameter is output impedance. Let me write impedance. Notation is RO that I have used. Now, what is that output impedance? It is RC in parallel with RL. And same thing will be there. RC in parallel with RL. See, the output impedance will never change. The output part for bypassed amplifier and for unbypassed amplifier will never change. It will remain same. The third parameter that we have derived is voltage gain. Voltage gain. AV. Now, what is this? It is HFE plus RC in parallel RL divided by HIE. Now, approximate value for voltage gain of unbypassed amplifier. You remember, we have directly written RC divided by RE. I am writing final equation. Is it? I am writing final equations only. Otherwise, before that RC divided by RE, we have large equation and calculations, large approximations actually. Is it? So, the fourth parameter is current gain. What is the notation we have used? Okay, AI was notation. Let me extend this line here somewhere and it will remain HFE, and for unbypassed also it will remain as HFE. The fifth parameter which we never use is a what was that? It is a power gain. Yes, it is a power gain, and we never use that power gain. So this is a kind of summary that we can have, because these equations I am going to use to design a common emitter single stage RC coupled amplifier. Is it? But now, as if we have finished with all those parameters, let's start with the design. The design of RC coupled amplifier. But see, instead of starting immediate design of RC coupled amplifier, we need to focus on something which is quite important, is it? Some approximation. For example, see, in case of amplifier, we have two, three things, is it? We have two capacitors. How many capacitors we have? 1A. We have coupling capacitors. And second thing, we have bypass capacitors. Now, while designing amplifier, we need to follow some approximate methods to calculate coupling capacitor as well as bypass capacitor. Now, what are those? First, we'll discuss about coupling capacitor. While calculating value of coupling capacitor, generally we calculate its impedance. For example, see, if I am saying I want to calculate input coupling capacitor Cin. Now, for Cin, I will calculate XC in. And what is that XC in? That is capacitive reactance. Roughly what I can say is impedance offered by that C in. And this I am going to write it as 10% input impedance is known. For if it is bypassed amplifier, then input impedance will be RB in parallel with HI or simply HI. If it is unbypassed amplifier, then this equation will come in picture, that is RB in parallel with HI RA 1 plus HFE. Is it? So this is what the first common guidelines to calculate bypass, sorry, coupling capacitor C in. For same way, I can calculate C out. For C out, I can have 10% of what? It is an output coupling capacitor, so it must be 10% of output impedance. Yes, that needs to be done because we are in approximate equations, we are in approximate calculations, so I need to put this. But now the question is, why you are calculating this XC in and XC out? Because one thing is known, that XC is equals to 1 divided by FC. Is it? If it is XC in, and then it must be C in. Yes, that, and what is that F? Is a lower cutoff frequency. Lower cutoff frequency of amplifier. Now, what is that lower cutoff frequency? See, in next chapter, that is in frequency response, you will study that frequency response also. But here, in a very short time, I'll explain what is that frequency response. It is a graph of frequency versus, and its shape will be like this. For practical amplifier, this is what the shape is. That, and somewhere here, we have to draw a 3 dB line. What is a 3 dB network? Still, in next chapter, I will tell you in detail what is that. So, this is lower cutoff frequency and this is higher. And the difference is called bandwidth of an amplifier. What bandwidth of an amplifier? Agreed. So, this F is nothing but lower cutoff frequency of an amplifier, that is FL, which is generally given in the design statement. Is it? And if it is not given, see, if it is not given, then we have to assume FL equals to 20 Hertz. Why 20 Hertz? Because it is an amplifier. Is it? See, at the start of the chapter, I told amplifiers. So, as if we are in small signals amplifiers, it means we are going to design and small audio amplifiers. So, whatever analysis we are doing is valid and applicable for audio amplifiers. So, if it is an audio amplifier, definitely it will work in the range of 20 Hertz to 20 kilohertz. So, if 20 Hertz, 20 kilohertz is the audio range, what does it mean? It means this 20 Hertz is nothing but lower cutoff frequency and 20 kilohertz is in amplifier design, this F is not given by default. You need to assume that we are using audio range, that is 20 Hertz. It is clear? See, now this calculation for coupling capacitor is done by approximate method. Now again, we have another capacitor, that is bypass capacitor. See, if you are designing, because bypass capacitor is not there, but in case of bypass amplifier, generally we use bypass amplifier all the time, then there is a CE which is connected in parallel with RE. Here also, for CE, what I will calculate? I will calculate XCE, which is nothing but 1 divided by 2 pi FCE. Now, what is that F? F is nothing but your FL. What is that FL? Lower cutoff frequency of an amplifier. If it is given, use it. Not given, 20 Hertz by default. Is it? XCE and this equation. But what is XCE? We have to assume that in which it is in parallel with. So those are few things that I wanted to tell you before starting with the design of an actual amplifier. Is it? This is the way, or this is how we generally calculate all the value of capacitors. And now the only thing is, we will calculate rest of the values for resistors, and then that is what our design is. Is it? So in next lecture, probably what I will do, I will start with one design problem. Is it? And I will solve the design problem step by step. Only one problem will solve, and after that I will give you some assignments depend on that design problem. Yes, and that's what the thing is. Is it? So meanwhile, you go through this analysis, you go through the summary itself. You should remember that summary, because every time at that practical design, this summary is very useful. Is it? So please go through it, and we'll meet and next lecture with design of an amplifier. Okay, thanks a lot then.